So far, for the solution to our design challenge, we plan to cut open the skin and tissue so that we can insert an antenna connected to a thin transmission line and direct it to where the tumor is located. Now, if we're going to put an antenna into a living person, we need to understand really well how the antenna will radiate and what, if any, health hazards this antenna might create. In other words, we first need to be able to predict what electric and magnetic fields are generated around the antenna, the strength of these fields, and their characteristics as they propagate away from the antenna. There are generally two ways to calculate electric and magnetic fields that are radiated by an antenna. For example, if we know the J current density generated by moving electrons across the length of our dipole antenna, or a comparable antenna, then one option is to follow what's called path 1. And in this case, we directly calculate E and H by solving Maxwell's equations. Path 1 works, path number 1 works really well if we let a computer solve Maxwell's equations for us. And for example, if we use a numerical algorithm and we program the computer to solve it. In this case, as long as we program it correctly, and we can let the computer do the hard work for us. If you take ECE 5340 or 6340, you'll learn more about how this is done. On the other hand, in this class, we're going to solve the problem analytically. In this case, it's much easier to follow a second path. I'll call this path number 2, even though it's going to involve two steps instead of just one. So to follow path 2, we're going to use what's called a vector magnetic potential, A, to simplify the analytical calculation. So first we're going to calculate A, and then we're going to use A to calculate E and H. Note that the vector magnetic potential, this A right here, is a human construct. It's not physical, meaning that we can't go out and measure a vector magnetic potential. Instead, we're only going to use this here to simplify the calculations for us to get from J here over to E and H. Take out your in-class project notebook and record that you'll be following path 2 in order to calculate the electromagnetic fields radiated by an antenna.